Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So in today's video we are going to see top 50 CSS interview questions. We already previously have made a video in which we have discussed top 50 HTML interview questions. So if you have not watched that, you can watch that too. We have a playlist related to it on our channel, so you can check that and you can go through all of those interview experiences. So let's start with today's video and let's see our first question. So what is CSS? CSS stands for Cascading Style Sheet. It is a popular styling language which is used with HTML to design websites. It can also be used with any XML documents including plain XML, SVG and XUL. Moving on to our next question. What is the origin of CSS? SGML, Standard Generalized Markup Language, is the origin of CSS. It is a language that defines markup languages. Moving on to the next question now. What are different variations of CSS? So following are the different variations of CSS: CSS 1, CSS 2.1, CSS 2, CSS 3, CSS 4. Let's see the next question now. What is the box model in CSS? Which CSS properties are a part of it? A rectangle box is wrapped around every HTML element. The box model is used to determine the height and width of the rectangle box. The CSS box consists of width and height, or in the absence of that, default values and the content inside, padding, borders, margins. Content, let's see what is meant by content. Actual content of the box where the text or the image is placed is called as content. Padding, area surrounding the content, space between the border and the content. Border, area surrounding the padding. Margin, area surrounding the border is called as margin. So you can even understand it in a better way by looking at the image below, that what is meant by different properties of CSS, which are content, padding, border and margin. Moving on to our next question. Name some CSS frameworks. CSS frameworks are libraries that makes web page styling easier. Some of them are Foundation, Bootstrap, Gumby, UKit, Semantic UI, etc. So let's see the next question now. What are the advantages of using CSS? The main advantages of using CSS are given below. Separation of content from presentation. CSS provides a way to present the same content in multiple presentation formats in mobile or desktop or laptop. Easy to maintain. CSS built effectively can be used to change the look and feel complete by making small changes. To make a global change, simply change the style and all elements in all the web pages will be updated automatically. Bandwidth, used effectively, the style sheets will be stored in the browser cache and they can be used on multiple pages without having to download them. So these are some of the advantages of using CSS or cascading style sheets. Moving on to the next question. What are the limitations of CSS? Disadvantages of CSS are below. Browser compatibility, some style selectors are supported and some are not. We have to determine which style is supported or not using the @support selector. Cross browser issue, some selectors behave differently in different browsers, which means that if they are supported in Chrome browser, then it might not support in Edge browser like so. There is no parent selector. Currently using CSS, you can't select a parent tag. Let's see the next question now, which is, what do you understand by the universal selector? A universal selector is a selector that matches any element's type's name instead of selecting elements of a particular type. So you can even see the example of a universal selector below. Moving on to the next question. How to include CSS in the web page? There are three methods to integrate CSS on the web pages, which are inline method, embedded or internal method, and external method, that is linked or imported CSS. So let's see what is meant by internal method, inline method first, that is what is meant by inline CSS. It is used to insert style sheets in HTML document. Internal method, it is used to add a unique style to a single document. And external CSS, it is used when you want to make changes on multiple pages. Moving on to the next question, tell us about the use of rule set. The rule set is used for identification of selectors which can be attached with other selectors. Two parts of rule set are: declaration block contains one or more semicolon separated declarations. Sector indicates the HTML element needed to be styled. So this was the use of rule set. Next question is, what is embedded style sheet? An embedded style sheet is a CSS style specification method used with HTML. You can embed the entire style sheet in an HTML document by using the style element. You can even see the example below. Before moving to the next question, if you are new to the channel, please subscribe it for seeing more such video. We regularly post interview related videos on our channel. Also, we post data structure and recruitment related videos on our channel. So if you have not checked those videos, you can check that too. Also, if you have not subscribed yet, please subscribe to the channel and also like the videos and share it amongst your friends. Moving on to the next question. What is a CSS selector? It is a string that identifies the elements to which a particular declaration apply. It is also referred as a link between the HTML document and the style sheet. It is the equivalent of HTML elements. There are several different types of selectors in CSS, namely CSS element selector, CSS ID selector, CSS class selector, CSS universal selector, or CSS group selector. So moving on to the next question now. Names of CSS style components. Some CSS style components are selector, property, value. Let's see the next question now. What is the use of CSS opacity? The CSS opacity property is used to specify the transparency of an element. In simple word, you can say that it specifies the clarity of the image. In technical terms, opacity is defined as a degree to which light is allowed to travel through an object. For example, image.trans, and you can mention the opacity for that. That is 0.4. So you can see the syntax or the code snippet below. Moving on to the next question. What is VH or VW, that is viewport height, viewport width in CSS? The answer for this question is, it's a CSS unit used to measure the height and width in percentage with respect to the viewport. It is used mainly in respective design techniques. Responsive design techniques, the measure VH is equal to 1/100 of height of the viewport. If the height of the browser is 1000 pixels, 1 VH is equals to 10 pixels. Similarly, if the width is 1000 pixels, then 1 view width is equal to 10 pixels. Moving on to our next question. Difference between reset versus normalized CSS. How do they differ? Reset CSS. CSS resets aims to remove all built-in browser styling. For example, margins, paddings, font sizes of all the elements are reset to be the same. Normalized CSS aims to make built-in browser styling consistent across browsers. It also corrects bugs from common browser dependencies. Let's see the next question now. What is the difference between inline block and block? So block element always start on a new line. They will also take space for the entire row or width. List of block elements are div tag, p tag, or paragraph tag. Inline elements don't start on a new line. They appear on the same line as the content and tags beside them. Some examples of inline elements are anchor tag, span tag, strong tag, and images tag. Inline block elements are similar to inline elements, except they can have padding and margins and set high and width value. Moving on to our next question. Is it important to test the web page in different browsers? It's most important to test a website in different browsers when you are first designing it or when making the major changes. However, it's also important to repeat these tests periodically since browsers go through a lot of updates and changes over a period of time. Moving on to the next question now. How do you specify units in the CSS? What are the different ways to do it? There are different ways to specify units in CSS, like pixels, em, pt, percentage, px, or pixel gives fine grained control and maintain alignment because one pixel or multiple of one pixel is guaranteed to look sharp. Pixel is not cascade. Em maintains relative size. You can have responsive fonts. Em will cascade. 1 em is equals to the current font size of the element or the browser default. If you send font size to 16 pixel, then 1 em will become equals to 16 pixel. The common practice is to set default body of font size to 62.5%, which is equals to 10 pixels. Point are traditionally used in print. 1 point equals to 1/72 inch, and it is a fixed size unit. Percentage sets the font size relative to the font size of the body. Hence, you have to set the font size of the body to a reasonable size. So you can see that these kinds of questions are very much important with respect to CSS, because here very much detailed values are given, whereas you can see that 1 point pointer is relevant to what in inch, and so on and so forth. So you should understand these questions very clearly. Moving on to our next question. Name the property used to specify the background color of an element. The background color property is used to specify the background color of the element. You can even see the example below how to use this property. Let's see the next question now. Name the property for controlling the image position in the background. The background position property is used to define the initial position of the background image. By default, the background image is placed on the top left of the web page. You can set the following position for the background image, that is center, top, bottom, left and right. Let's move on to the next question now. Name the property for controlling the image scroll in the background. The background attachment property is used to specify if the background image is fixed or scroll with the rest of the pages in the browser window. If you set the fixed the background image, then the image not move during the scrolling in the browser. Let's take an example with the fixed background image. So you can see if you want to make your image move on the browser, how you can make it by making the use of background attachment property. Moving on to the next question now. What is meant by RGB stream? RGB represents color in CSS. The three streams are namely red, green and blue. The intensity of colors is represented using numbers, that is from 0 to 256. This allows CSS to have a spectrum of visible colors. Moving on to the next question. What was the purpose of developing CSS? CSS was developed to define the visual appearances of websites. It allows developers to separate the structure and content of a website. That was not possible before. Moving ahead with our next question. What is the difference between a class and an ID? Class is a way of using HTML elements for styling. They are not unique and have multiple elements, whereas ID is unique and it can be assigned to a single element. Moving ahead with our next question. How can you target S3 and S2 with the same styling? Multiple elements can be targeted by separating with a comma. So you can even see the example for it. S2 comma S3. If you write it in this way, then you can target S3 and S2 with the same styling. Moving on with our next question. Name media types allowed by CSS. The different media types allowed by CSS are speech, audio, visual, tactile media, continuous or paged media, grip media or bitmap, interactive media. Moving on to the next question now. Name some font related CSS attributes. The font related CSS attributes are font style, variant, weight, family, size and etc. Let's see the next question now. Explain responsive web design. Responsive design is a web page creation approach that uses flexible images, flexible layouts and CSS media queries. This design approach aims to build web pages that detect and orient the screen size of the visitors so that the layout can be changed accordingly. Let's move on to the next question. Tell us about the general CSS nomenclature. In CSS, the styling commands are written in value and property fashion. CSS includes a system terminator, semicolon. The entire style is wrapped in curly braces and attached to the selector. This creates a style sheet that can be applied to a HTML page. So you can see that sometimes you can even see such questions where you know the answer for it, but due to some technical names, you might not understand that what the interviewer is asking. So if you have gone through these questions once before sitting for your interview, it will be very good for your interview. Let's move on to the next question now. What is a CSS preprocessor? What are SAS, LESS and stylus? Why do people use them? CSS preprocessor is a tool used to enhance the basic functionality and let us use the complex logical syntax such as variables, functions, mixins and code nesting within vanilla CSS script themselves. SAS, syntactically awesome style sheets, uses .sass extension. It is used for indentation. It doesn't use semicolons or curly brackets. LESS, linear style sheets, uses .less extension. It is very easy to use and add to any JavaScript project by using npm or less.js file. Here @ is used to define the variables. Stylus provides great flexibility in writing syntax. It is able to use native CSS as well as the inclusion of bracket, colons, semicolons. There is no need to use @ or $ to define the variables. People use SAS, LESS and stylus in order to extend the basic functionality of the vanilla JSS. Moving on with our next question, which is what are the difference between adaptive designer and responsive design. Adaptive design main focus is to develop a website in multiple fixed layout sizes, offers good control over the design to develop variation in screens. It is a very time consuming and task takes a lot of effort to build the best possible adaptive design, as examining it will not will need to go for many options with respect to the realities of the user and user. There are 6 standard screen sizes for the appropriate layout. They are 320 pixels, 480 pixels, 760 pixels, 960 pixels, 1200 pixels, 600 pixels to design. Responsive design, main focus is to show content with respect to browser space, offers less control over the design, it takes less time to build the design, and there is no screen size issue irrespective of the content. It uses CSS media queries to design the screen layers with respect to specific devices and property changes in the screen. So one of the very common question that is being asked in CSS interview is difference between adaptive and responsive design. Moving on to the next question, how are CSS selectors matched against the elements by the browser? Initially, there is a filtration of elements in the DOM via browsers with respect to key selectors that are traversed until we get the parent elements to determine the matches. Then the browser works on finding all the span elements present in the DOM and traverses them to the parent elements to check whether they are matched to the paragraph P elements. At last, when the browser finds all the matches as a parent, the matching process will be stopped and there will be a black color applied to the content. Moving on with our next question, how is the border box different from the content box? Border box consists of properties such as content, padding, and the border with respect to the height and width. However, content box is a default value property used for box sizing, as well as it helps to add border and padding to give the proper height and width to the box without having a border and padding properties. Let's see the next question now. Difference box sizing property. So there are different box sizing properties present in CSS. They are content box, padding box, and border box. Let's move on to the next question, which is how to center align a div inside another div. A div inside another div A is center aligned with the help of aligning div property to content via HTML script and CSS to the element in the DOM, that is document object manipulation. Moving on to our next question, what is grid system? The CSS grid system is a type of powerful layout two-dimensional system with respect to columns and rows. Let's see the next question now, which is what are the different ways to hide the elements using CSS? Display none, visibility hidden, position absolute. So by using any of the three ways, you can hide the elements using the CSS. Let's see the next question now, difference between CSS grid and flexbox. So this is one of the very common questions that is regularly being asked. So CSS grid layout is a two-dimensional system along with rows and columns. It is used for larger size layouts. Flexbox is a grid layout with a one-dimensional system either within a row or a column. It is used for components of an application. Moving on to the next question, how does CALCI work? CALCI can be used to specify the results of the mathematical operations of two or more elements. For example, to specify the width elements by addition of two or more elements. We can even write the CALCI in the below mentioned syntax, whereas you need to mention the CALCI and in the bracket you need to mention the pixel that needs to be added. Moving on to the next question, what does star, curly braces, box sizing, border box do? What are its advantages? Box sizing border box is used to provide the inner dimension for the elements in the document by providing padding and border with respect to the height and width of the content. Moving on to the next question, what does important means in C++? Important or exclamation important. This means that the style in the CSS has the highest precedence. Also, the cascading property will be overridden with it. So if you mention important, then it means that the CSS has the highest precedence over all the other CSS that is present in your style sheet. Moving on to the next question, what is progressive rendering? How do you implement progressive rendering on the website? What are its advantages? Progressive rendering is the process of improving the performance of a web page with respect to loading time in order to display the content speedily. The use of the lazy loading of the image with the help of intersection observer API via viewport. Let's see the next question now. Does style1.css have to be downloaded and parsed before style.css2 can be fetched? No, the CSS file will be downloaded via browser in order to appear on the HTML page. So you don't have to download any of the CSS files in any order. It will be downloaded automatically via the browser. Moving on to the next question, how to determine if the browser supports a certain feature? @ support tag in the CSS is used to scan and determine whether the browser supports a certain feature or not. Let's see the next question now. How does absolute partitioning work? Absolute partitioning is used to place the element which is then removed from the HTML document from the normal workflow without creating any space for the element in the HTML page layout. The element can be positioned respectively to the closest position ancestor. Otherwise, if the ancestor is not found, the element is placed with respect to the initial container box. The values provided to the top right, left and bottom determine the final position of the element. Moving on to the next question. What is meant by CSS working under the hood? When a browser displays a document, it combines style information and documentation content. The documentation is processed in two stages, that is, conversion of HTML and CSS into document object model, DOM displaying the contents of the browser. So in this way, CSS works under the hood. Moving on to the next question, define gradient in CSS. A property of CSS that allows displaying smooth transformation between two or more specified colors. The types of gradients are linear and radial. Let's see the next question now. What are the benefits of CSS sprites? If a web page has a large number of images that takes a longer time to load because each image separately sends out an HTTP request, the concept of CSS sprites is used to reduce the loading time for a web page because it combines the various small images into one image. It reduces the number of HTTP requests and hence the loading time. Let's see the next question, that is, what is the difference between logical tags and physical tags? Physical tags are referred to as presentational markup while logic tags are useless for appearances. Physical tags are newer versions, on the other hand, logical tags are old and concentrate on content. So with this, we have completed our 50 CSS interview questions. So if you are new to the channel, please subscribe to the channel. And if you feel that this video has helped you in some way, please give it a like and also share it amongst your friends. Also, if you are preparing for your upcoming interviews, you can check the playlist section of our channel where we have posted a lot of content related to the interview preparation. Thanks for watching.